Lemon balm makes a delicious tea, is known for its calming effects, and if not contained in a pot, may take over your yard. But today we're going to go over some benefits of lemon balm that you probably don't know about and may really surprise you, especially number 5. And if you stick with me to the end, I will show you how to make a fresh tincture of lemon balm. Small studies have shown that lemon balm tincture taken daily can improve memory in both non-impaired and dementia subjects. While more studies are needed to prove this increased memory effect, lemon balm has been used for this reason for hundreds of years. The dose studied was 60 drops, or about a quarter of a teaspoonful daily. Lemon balm has antispasmodic and calming effects, making it a go-to herb for GI issues such as indigestion, diarrhea, and colic. While you should always check with your healthcare professional before taking any supplements yourself, and especially before giving your supplements to children, lemon balm has been traditionally used to help ease colic in babies. Ask your doctor if giving 1 to 2 teaspoons of weak tea, not tincture, 2 or 3 times a day might benefit your child. Because of its antiviral properties, lemon balm cream or salve is an effective remedy for treating cold sores and shingles, both of which are caused by the chickenpox virus. Make a lemon balm lip balm to keep with you to use whenever you feel that cold sore coming on. Research has shown that lemon balm has some mild antihistamine effects. It is also anti-inflammatory, so crushing the leaves and rubbing them on insect bites can relieve the swelling and itching. If you don't have fresh lemon balm leaves handy when you get bit, you can use lemon balm tincture in the same way. Apply it immediately when you notice the bite. Because tinctures are made with alcohol, it can sting if you scratch before application. A study of X-ray technicians who work around radiation daily showed that drinking a cup of lemon balm tea twice a day significantly reduced the DNA damage that was associated with this job. Another study showed that drinking lemon balm tea significantly reduced skin damage caused by UVB rays from prolonged sun exposure. While you should still wear long sleeves and a hat when you're going to be out in the sun for extended periods of time, drinking a cup of lemon balm tea twice a day would be a delicious way to further protect yourself from a sunburn now and skin cancer later. Would you like a list of herbs that can be used for specific issues so you can plan your medicinal herb garden? I will leave a link in the description below so you can get one. So are you ready to make your fresh tincture? Start by harvesting your lemon balm. It will take you more than you expect, but you need enough to fill a pint jar 2/3 full and firmly packed. Don't worry if you have harvested more than you need for the tincture. Whatever is left over, you can dehydrate into tea. Once you have your lemon balm harvested, you will also need to gather the following: 80 proof vodka, a measuring cup, a pint mason jar with a lid, scissors or a knife and cutting board to chop the herb, a funnel, and something to pack the herb tightly into the jar. I use a rolling pin. First, remove the leaves of lemon balm from the stem, then give the lemon balm a rough cut to increase the surface area so the vodka can extract the medicine more completely. Then place the chopped lemon balm in the jar. Pack it in tightly to get it all in. Next, measure out the vodka. We will need about 240 ml, which is a cup. Pour this over the lemon balm leaves. Make sure that all of the lemon balm is under the vodka and that the vodka level is nearly to the brim of the jar. You may need to add just a bit more vodka to ensure that the herb is completely covered. Then put the lid on the jar and give it a few shakes just to make sure that there is no air trapped in between the leaves. Open the jar and add more vodka if needed. Label this so you remember what's in there, especially if you make a lot of tinctures. Then put it in a place out of direct sunlight. Once a day for a week, you will need to shake the jar just to make sure that all of the lemon balm is in the alcohol. Let your tincture sit for at least 4 weeks before straining off the liquid. Put the liquid in the final container and label it with at least the name of the product, fresh lemon balm tincture, and the date it was made. You may want to add more information to your label, such as what it's used for and what dose to use. This tincture should last indefinitely, or at least until you use it all up. If you're ready to learn more about growing and making your own herbal medicines for you and your family, consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell so that you will get this important information every week. Thank you for joining me today. Stay healthy Drink your lemon balm tea before going out into that hot sun, and have a blessed week.